So I've spent quite a few videos on talking about this maximum efficiency for solar energy conversion. And in the last few videos, I derived this what is called this Landsberg limit for solar energy conversion, and it's given by this formula. It's a very important limit, so let me put it in a box. And sometimes this is also known as the thermodynamic limit of solar energy conversion. And if I give this formula some numbers, so if I take an ambient temperature of 300 Kelvin and a temperature of the sun to be 6000 Kelvin, this efficiency turns out to be approximately 93.3%. And the way I calculated this Landsberg limit was I essentially applied the first and second laws of thermodynamics. So I equated all these energy fluxes, and I equated all these entropy fluxes, which I have labeled in blue over here. And another assumption that I made was there, besides these entropy fluxes, which are associated with the incoming solar radiation and the radiation which is generated from the cell, and the radiation which is and the heat which is given out to the ambient. Besides that, I assume that basically there is no other process which is generating entropy. And in particular, we assume that whenever this energy from the sun is absorbed by this cell, there is no extra entropy generation. Similarly, when this emission of radiation takes place out from this cell, there is again no entropy generation over there. And that can be in principle true, but it's not often possible, especially for systems which obey reciprocal optics. So these typically there's entropy associated with the absorption and emission process, and these processes are typically irreversible. So this absorption and emission of radiation into a solar cell is typically a irreversible process, and there's an entropy generated entropy which is associated with this absorption and emission process. So if I take this radiation from the sun, and when it gets absorbed into the cell, there's an entropy associated with that. So like, let me call it as entropy associated with absorbing this energy, and it's given by this formula, where it's dependent on the energy flux from the sun, and it's given by this formula. And looking at this formula, it kind of makes a sense that why there'll be a entropy associated with this process. So this 4 by 3 ES by TS, that is kind of the entropy which is associated with the with this incoming radiation. Now, this is when this radiation is traveling in free space or in vacuum. When I absorb that into a cell, then I give that a medium, and the entropy now essentially for the same energy becomes ES by TC. So if I subtract these two terms, this is the extra entropy which is associated with this absorption process. So you can see, why kind of this formula make sense. Similarly, there's an entropy which is associated with the emission process, and this is given by this process, which is when the energy which is located inside the cell is given out in the form of this radiation. And this entropy associated with this emission process is essentially 1 by 3 EC, with the energy which is given out by this cell in the form of radiation, divided by the temperature of the cell. And again, I can kind of make peace with this equation. And the way I can make peace is that when this energy is emitted out, it has a entropy term which has a 4 by 3 of EC by TC, and when this energy was located inside the cell, it has an entropy of EC by TC. So there's an extra 1 by 3 EC by TC term which is associated with this emission process. So These two entropies are inevitably present in this energy conversion. So the net entropy generation is by default involves these two entropies. So when I take this entropy generated in this process, I need to take into account these two entropies over here. So let me do that, and let me plug these equations into the second law of thermodynamics. So this is the second law of thermodynamics, and I had previously, when I was deriving the Landsberg limit, I had written it down. So I had written it down in terms of the entropy of the incoming radiation plus the entropy generated, and this was equal to the entropy of the radiation which was given out plus entropy due to the heat which was given out to the ambient. So in this entropy generated, I add the entropies due to the absorption and emission process. So let me rewrite this equation now with this added entropy. So I get 4 by 3 Ta by Ts term, plus I get this Ta by Es term over here. And then I have the net entropy generation, and I include the entropy due to absorption, and that is given by this formula, where it's Es 1 by Tc minus 4 by 3 temperature of the sun, plus I have the energy extra entropy associated with the emission process, and that is given by 1 by 3 Ec by Tc. So this is now equal to Q by Es, and that is the term that I need for calculating my efficiency, plus this other term, which is 4 by 3 Ec by Es and Ta by Tc. So now, you know, let me arrange some terms over here. So I'll get essentially this Es will cancel out from the numerator and denominator over here. So I'll get a Ta by Tc term from over here. And then I'll get a minus 4 by 3 Ta by Ts term over here. So I'll get a minus, I'll get a minus 4 by 3 Ta by Ts term over here. And that essentially cancels out with this plus 4 by 3 Ta by Ts term over here. So these two terms cancel out. And then I'll get 1 by 3 Ec by Es over here, and multiplied by Ta by Tc. And this is equal to Q by Es. And then I have another plus 4 by 3 Ec by Es Ta by Tc term over here. So this plus 4 by 3, when I come bring it over to this side, it becomes minus 4 by 3, and adding 1 by 3 to it, so I'm left with a coefficient of minus 1 over here. So what I get is this Q by Es term. This becomes equal to Ta by Tc, which is coming from here. And then there's a common Ta by Tc over here, so I can take it common out. And then I get a minus Ec by Es term over here. And I know that for these two black bodies, the cell and the sun, the ratio of these energy fluxes is given by the Stefan Boltzmann law. So I can further simplify and write it as, in terms of temperature, as the temperature of the cell divided by the temperature of the sun, and multiplied and exponent or a power of 4 over here. So what I can now do is I can take this equation for Qs by Es and substitute over in this efficiency relationship. So this is the same analysis that I had used for the Landsberg limit, but I have now derived this Qs Q by Es term, taking into account the extra entropy which are generated during the absorption and the emission process. So when I do that, then Basically, you can see if I take this QS by ES over here, I have this TA by TA by TC, and then I have a term which is very much looking like this. So I have a term which is 1 minus TC by TS, the whole thing raised to the power of 4. So I can take this 1 minus TC by TS, whole thing raised to the power of 4 common, and what I get for the value of efficiency is that I get this relationship where I have this term which is taken out to be common, and then inside this term I have 1 minus TA by TC. So this is my final formula for my efficiency, and this is an important one, so let me put this in a box as well. And this limit is what is called as a Blackbody limit of solar energy conversion. And I'm out of time in this video, but in the next video I'll see what is the maximum value which comes out to be from this formula, and also the implications of the way this final formula comes out to be. So see you in the next video.